In this video, I'm going to take you to some of the best places to go to in order to get a better sense for Sarasota. My name is Katrin Fitzmaider. I'm a realtor here in Sarasota County. If you don't know my channel yet, this channel is all about Florida insights with a focus on Sarasota. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe to this channel and let's get started. So we're going to start off from South Sarasota. I'm actually in a community called Prestencia, which is in Palmer Ranch. So just a little bit about Prestencia. It's a golfing community, a gated community. There's a lot of mature trees around here. The golf course is very popular. A lot of people that move into this community are golfers, though not everybody. Some people just like the community because of how central it is here in Sarasota, and it's just very pretty too. We're gonna go from Palmer Ranch, we're gonna drive through Golf Gate, right over the South Bridge to Siesta Key. And from Siesta Key Beach, we're gonna go downtown Sarasota. We're gonna stop by the Bayfront area, which is one of my favorite parks in all of Sarasota. Next, we're gonna take the Ringling Bridge over Toledo Key. We'll drive through downtown just to give you a bit of an idea of what downtown Sarasota is like. We're gonna make a stop at the Bay Sarasota, which is an awesome place because there's so much happening and there's gonna be so much happening in the future. I always compare the Bay Sarasota to the pier in downtown St. Pete because I really think it's gonna become the heartbeat of downtown Sarasota. Look it up if you don't know much about it, or maybe see this video over here, which talks about everything coming to Sarasota in 2022 and beyond. So what I'm gonna do with this video is also make some cuts. So it's not gonna be completely raw, but I did wanna give you a raw style video. I'm gonna get us to the most important points in this video. I'm also gonna time it just for you to get a really good sense of how, in reality, how small Sarasota is as a city. Right now we're driving through Golf Gate. We're actually on Golf Gate Drive, which kind of takes you through the neighborhood. Palmer Ranch is great for those that are looking for South Sarasota living, more resort style communities. It's a bit more expensive. The average home now will probably run you around $500,000. Golf Gate, which is adjacent to Palmer Ranch, is actually even closer to Siesta Key, and the homes here are more affordable. Most of them are in a deed-restricted community, single-family, ranch-style homes. There's lots of fixer-uppers to still be bought if they're available in the market, that is. The prices right now, the average price in Golf Gate will probably be anywhere between $300,000 to $400,000. When I left Prestencia, it was around 2:56 p.m., and I'm going to let you know what time it's going to be when we get to Siesta Key Beach, and that's going to give you a good idea of how far Palmer Ranch is from Siesta Key Beach. And a lot of it is going to be contingent upon the traffic, but you are going to have to deal with some traffic, some days more and some days less, depending on the time of the year and the time of the day. So we just went over the Gulf Intercoastal Bridge here, and I was probably on the bridge for about 2 or 3 minutes. So there's a lot of traffic. Today's Saturday. On the weekends, it can take quite a long time to get to Siesta Key because of the traffic congestion that happens over the bridges and also on Midnight Pass. Traffic is moving on Midnight Pass, but not moving fast enough for me. Lots of stops along the way, waiting for people to cross the street, as you just saw, and cars just are driving, what, 5 miles per hour, a little bit more now. Getting really close to the entrance of Siesta Key Beach. We're gonna make a left onto the parking lot, and it's gonna be interesting to see how packed it is or not. Now, it is very cold today, at least for Sarasotians. For you guys up north, it probably isn't at all. You would love this weather, but for us, it's quite freezing. So I would say the only reason why this beach may not be packed today on a Saturday is because a lot of people might think it's too cold, because again, it's like 74 degrees, I just checked. Yeah, there's lots of people here. Seems like almost all the parking spots are taken. This is kind of the main area to park on Siesta Key Beach. Sure, eventually you'll find a parking space. It's just a matter of having patience. Actually, what I tend to do is I tend to follow people that are heading back to their cars, and I literally wait for them to get into the car. I'm not gonna go all the way into Siesta Key, but what I did wanna point out is just how wide the beach is. It takes about 6 to 7 minutes, depending on how fast you walk, to get from the parking lot to the water. People love the sand here because it's so powdery-like. It's made out of 99% quartz, and the other benefit of it just feeling so great and looking so great is that it doesn't heat up in the warmest of summer days. 29 p.m. and we're gonna go and exit over the Northern Bridge, and I'm gonna take you through the cute little village that we have here in Siesta Key Beach, which I'm gonna have to go and drive through anyways. So that's going to give you an opportunity to kind of see the village from the car. So if you were to stay really close to Siesta Key Beach, you could walk from Siesta Key Beach to the village, but it is somewhat of an extended walk. It would take you, I don't know, if I were to guess, maybe 15 minutes, 20 minutes from the beach. We're in the village, and this is kind of like the main section of the village. There's lots of cute little restaurants and bars, live entertainment at nighttime, rent these little scooters. I love the village, it's great. So we're gonna go over the Northern Bridge, which we're doing right now. And the view here to downtown Sarasota to the left, I really shouldn't be looking because I'm driving, is absolutely stunning. We're gonna hop on Tamiami Trail 41, which is going to take us downtown. We're on Tamiami on 41, and pretty soon that's gonna take us around the Bayfront area. It's a beautiful drive around the Bayfront area. It's actually one of my favorite places to be in. And luckily for me and you, we're gonna actually stop by the Bayfront area, which is this beautiful park with amazing views to the city, to the Ringling Bridge, to the bay. Plus there's a lot to do. You have yoga in the parks. You can just picnic there or just walk around or lounge. So I'm gonna make a left into the parking lot, which is right adjacent to the Bayfront area. There's a lot to do in the Bayfront Park, really, for everybody. There's a playground here. There's O'Leary's, which is a bar. They play live music at nighttime. People come here to just walk around. Sometimes they bike or they walk their dogs. There are plenty of activities that are being held in the park, including yoga. What you're looking at here is an art exhibit called Embracing Our Differences. It's held every year, and it's where students submit their artwork in support of diversity. And what I'm going to do now is go over the Ringling Bridge. I was actually going to go through downtown Sarasota first, but I think it makes more sense to do it this way just because of how traffic is flowing. Now there's somewhat of a slowdown here right by the Bayfront Park because they're building a roundabout, and that's changing the traffic pattern, but it's also slowing it down somewhat. I know what the purpose is behind the roundabout, and that is really to make things safer for not just pedestrians but also those driving a car. And if you actually look at research, it dramatically reduces the amount of accidents that can happen. Since they started working on the roundabout downtown here, it's just been an absolute nightmare. So if you're going to be driving downtown, especially around the Bayfront area, you just want to make sure that you know how the traffic pattern works. We're going to go over the Ringling Bridge to get to Lido Key. In Lido Key is St. Armour's Circle. We're going to go around St. Armour's Circle and then stop at North Lido Beach, which to me is the most beautiful beach if you're going to want to see an amazing sunset. So I usually go there for sunset watching. When it comes to the beaches in Sarasota, we have so many to choose from. I usually go to Siesta Key for the Drum Circle, which is Sunday evenings. Sometimes I go to Turtle Beach for the sunsets because it's closer to where I live. If I have a bit more time, I usually do like to come to North Lido for the sunsets. So you'll get a feel for all the different beaches. You'll get an idea of where to go for what, depending what you're in the mood for. We're entering St. Armand's Circle, and there's so much to do in terms of shopping and restaurants and bars. A lot of tourists will typically frequent here, but some of the locals will come here too, especially when it comes to dining out. There are two restaurants I absolutely love here. One of them is Shore Restaurant, which is more of an American cuisine type of restaurant. I like the vegetarian food. I'm actually vegetarian, so I'll come here a lot to eat their salads. They have really good cocktails. Then there's Columbia Restaurant, which is arguably the most famous restaurant here on St. Armand Circle, and it's great for more of that Spanish, Latin type of food. Now the question is, will we get parking at North Lido Beach where I wanted to park at? We're on John Ringling Boulevard. Before you make a left to go further down Lido Key, there's an entrance to the right with parking, which is for North Lido Beach. And this is where I just pulled in right now. So we're at the entrance of North Lido Beach. Right by North Lido Beach is this new building that's being built. It's a residential building. There's some criticism around it just because of how it looks, architecturally speaking. I actually love it. Kind of reminds me of a ship. I come here for the sunset watching. I really think that the sunsets here are beautiful. Plus, there's not as many people here as there would be on Siesta Key. That's another reason why I like to come here. In the far distance is Lido Beach, and then beyond Lido Beach is South Lido Beach. So there's essentially three different beaches here on this stretch. So it's 4:35 p.m. We're heading over to the Ringling Bridge back to downtown Sarasota. Yeah, I must say that this view of downtown Sarasota and the Ringling Bridge is just my absolute favorite. It's just beautiful, and every time I drive over it, I'm just in awe of how amazing downtown Sarasota is from a visual standpoint, and of course from everything there is to enjoy in downtown Sarasota, the restaurants, the bars, you know, the art scene. Small things sometimes come in great packages, right? And that is downtown Sarasota. It's not the biggest city, but there's enough to do. We're getting really close to the Bay Sarasota. I'm gonna turn a left soon here. Now, the Bay Sarasota is an initiative that looks to transform about 55 acres, or maybe it's 53 acres of land right around the Bay Area to become a destination where people can go eat out, entertainment, parks. It's gonna take some time to get us to kind of what that master plan is looking like from a conceptual standpoint, maybe 10 to 15 years, depending on how much money they're able to raise. But they've already made so many strides over the last year, especially. They built this beautiful walkway and the pedestrian bridge that just opened up a few months ago. And there's so much more in store for us in 2022. Right over there is a view to the Ringling Bridge. This whole area is going to look very different in about 10 to 15 years from now. Up there is the Van Wassel. Hi. I usually come here for sunset watching. There are a few lookup piers. There's a walkway that goes all around the Van Wassel and a pedestrian bridge which is behind it. Like you see, there's beautiful views of the water. Just come down here, get to know the area and see its transformation over the next few years. It's gonna be amazing to witness. I'm gonna take us into some places downtown just for you to get to know the area. Right now we're on 41. Right in front of us is the West End. There's a beautiful roof deck bar and restaurant. If you haven't been there, I suggest you go just to see the spectacular views of downtown Sarasota. It's also one of the highest views that you can have here in Sarasota. Right now I'm on Fruitville. If Fruitville goes through downtown Sarasota, it's also what divides the Rosemary District from the other neighborhoods in downtown. So the Rosemary District is towards the left of Fruitville. I'm actually going to make a right on Coconut Avenue, and I'm going to show you some places there. We're going to go up Main Street. Main Street is essentially the central part of downtown. Okay, we're on Coconut heading over to the central part of downtown. We're going to pass Florida Studio Theater to my right. This is an excellent theater for improv classes or to see shows in. To the left, there's a white building here. That's the Art Ovation. If you were to stay downtown Sarasota, I would suggest you stay here. There's a roof deck bar. I love the hotel. There's a lot of art on display because, hey, it is Art Ovation, so they have to stay true to their name. I think one of the best ways to actually get a feel for the neighborhood is to drive through it and then spend some time in the neighborhood, maybe walk around. There's a lot of restaurants, a lot of bars on Main Street. And on the weekends, it will get much more crowded. Right now, not that many people out yet, but it's relatively early. Famous club called the Gator Club. It's to the right, and people go there for live music, jazz, blues. And here to the left, you're probably not gonna be able to see it, but it's Madison City Grill, which also offers live music with dining. So Whole Foods is essentially in the center of downtown Sarasota, so I'm walking distance for most people. So I'm gonna cross Fruitville, which is gonna take us right into Rosemary District. To me, the Rosemary District is the most exciting part of downtown to live in, partially because it's more affordable than being right in central downtown, right? To be closer in Main Street, be closer to the Bayfront Park, it's gonna cost you more money. But this is close enough to everything that downtown Sarasota has to offer. Plus, it's adjacent to the Bay Sarasota, which is up and coming. So I think buying the Rosemary District, though it's fast evolving, you're buying for today, but you're also buying for tomorrow. I like to compare the Rosemary District to a cross between Soho and today's Harlem in New York City. It's just an excellent place to live in. There's a big initiative to establish the Rosemary District as the arts district in downtown Sarasota. And so you'll see a lot of murals on walls, and they're trying to get more murals up on different buildings. If you enjoyed this video, please like this video. Also think about subscribing to this channel. If you need a realtor in Sarasota County, I would love to team up with you. I can be reached via my telephone number, or you can email me anytime. And thank you so much for tuning in today. I always appreciate it when you do. Take care.